Hey guys, what is up? Welcome to my channel. For today's video, I'm gonna try out some newly reformulated and new to me eyebrow products from Charlotte Tilbury. We're gonna do the brows. You're gonna get a little bit of a brow tutorial. And yeah, let's just get into it. Hi guys, if you're new here, my name is Morgan. I am a product knowledge enthusiast. I just love knowing anything and everything about all of the new makeup on the market and sharing my thoughts with you guys. And I'm a huge Charlotte Tilbury fan, a Charlotte Tilbury collector. And one portion of makeup that I was always missing from my Charlotte Tilbury collection was eyebrows. And she recently came out with a big eyebrow product launch. Now online it says this is still early access, like it's not officially released, but the link is still working if you want to order it. And she launched a new brow pencil, a new brow gel, and then she reformulated her already existing brow product. I've never tried any of her pre-existing brow products, so I can't tell you if the new formulation is going to be better, but she reformulated her brow lift, which is similar to the Benefit, the slanted one. It's like a thicker slanted one. I can't remember what it's called right now, but that's kind of what that one is like. That's newly reformulated. She also reformulated her legendary brows, which I'm gonna try today with you guys. And then she came out with two new eyebrow formulas, the Brow Fix Clear Brow Gel, and then we now have a Brow Cheat Micro Precision Brow Pencil. So this one's gonna be a nice thin one. So I'm really excited to try all of these out. So I ordered the Supermodel Brow Kit. It was $68 from the Charlotte Tilbury website. And if you order the brow kit, I know my eyeliner is like really wonky today. I had a full day of work. Okay, I came home, I slapped some stuff on my face, so I'm not having the best makeup or hair. It's okay, I just want to play with eyebrows, that's all that matters. So when you do this kit, you can choose between a brow lift or a brow cheat, which is the thin eyebrow pencil, which is the new one, or the newly reformulated thicker slanted one. So I of course went for the new thin one. I prefer thin pencils anyways. Let's get to it. So I want to first try the Legendary Brows Micro Precision Tinted Brow Gel. So this is newly reformulated. It is $23. I got mine in the shade Soft Brown. I prefer to get lighter shades in tinted brow gels just because if I feel like they're too dark, if I don't get precise application, it makes me look extra dirty. So I feel like the lighter the color, the easier it is to work with. And here's what the component itself looks like. It has a 6-month shelf life and it is made in the USA, but the materials are sourced internationally. So when you twist the cap, this really is a micro gel. And I really like tinted brow gels. It's what I normally wear to work. I barely wear any makeup to work. Normally, I don't even wear any makeup to work, but I will put a brow gel through my brows and I like for it to be tinted. So we're just gonna try it on this brow just to see what color we can get. Yeah, I'm really happy with this soft brown color because it's not overwhelming my brows. I feel like if I got something darker, it would overwhelm my brows. Now, it is only lightly tinted. Again, I'm not really sure if it's because of my color that I got, but it doesn't seem to carry too much pigment, which I prefer. I think it makes the brows look less messy if you're dealing with a tinted product like this. And it does give my brows some shape. It separates them. I think it makes them look really nice and natural for natural days. This is a great product for when you're not wearing makeup or you're kind of doing a no makeup makeup look. So here's what I know my brows look a little bit wonky. That is not the fault of the product. That's the fault of me because I haven't gotten my eyebrows done in a year and I've been trying to tweeze my brows for the last year and I'm not doing a very good job of it. But anyways, you have a lot of flexibility in directing the hairs and they're staying pretty well, but it's still a soft enough product. Like you can feel that your eyebrows will stick where you want it to, but you do have a lot of play time. I'm like bothered by this, whatever is going on down here. I'm not sure, but you'll see I'm going back and forth and my brows don't look crazy. You guys know I don't like this brow look. Boom, instantly made them look thicker though. Wow, I really like that. And when I did run my fingers over it a second ago, I did get some tint on my finger, but it's not overwhelming. I've dealt with brow gels that were just way too wet and way too patchy on my eyebrows. I really, really like this product so far. Okay, let's go into the next product. We're gonna try the Brow Cheat Micro Precision Pencil. This is $34. So she ain't cheap for eyebrows. You know, you go through eyebrow products so fast. You don't want them to be too expensive. At $34, it's only $25, which is a big chunk cheaper. And I kept talking about in this video how expensive it was because in my head it was $34. In reality, it is a little bit more affordable. And not only that, but the brow refills are only $15. So you would refill the pencil part. So that actually makes it a little bit more affordable, if you will, making it cheaper than like Benefit and ABH as well. So just keep that in mind when I say this is really expensive, I don't know if I'd repurchase it. Now knowing what I know after the fact, it actually is a lot more affordable than it seems, so I like it a little bit more. So there are, it looks like, 8 shades. I was a little bit confused about what shade I wanted to get. I ended up getting Natural Brown. I'm not sure if that's the correct shade, but it's very nice looking. Here is what, oh wow, so this has a mini slant to it. I thought it was going to be more like the Benefit regular one, but you can see it does have a slant, but it's still very, very small. I normally don't really care for a shape like this because at first you love it because you have all the sharp edges because of the triangle, but they do wear down after one or two uses and then you lose the definition that you get with that. And then you of course have a spoolie. So let's compare colors, just curiosity's sake. So like I said, Natural Brown in Charlotte Tilbury has a little bit of waxiness that I really like. So that's the color Natural Brown. I'm pulled out Benefit number 4, the Precisely My Brow Pencil. So the thinner line right here is the Benefit's a little bit deeper. That's number 4 if you need it for shade reference. Let's do ColourPop Brow Boss in Brunette. So that's Brunette, that lightest one. E.L.F. Instant Lift Brow Pencil in the shade, I think it's medium brown. Neutral Brown. So this is E.L.F. Neutral Brown. So those are the 3. They all kind of are in the same family. Let's go in, try this out. And by the way, this is going to be interchangeable, so you will be able to pull it out and pop a new one in, which will save you a little bit of money. But anyways, if you've ever wondered how I do my eyebrows, first of all, what's great about this is you can use the tip, like I said, to really create fine brow hairs, but that's not going to last long. That's the only downside about this shape, because it won't be this sharp forever, which is why I normally don't like brow products shaped like this. But it's depositing, wow, okay, a really nice amount of color. I just messed up. It's okay. It's waxy, but it still has some creaminess to it. I will say I would prefer if it was just maybe like a touch waxier, but I typically prefer waxier pencils compared to most people. I think it's a really nice in between, and that was a really nice, easy application. It's waxy enough so that it doesn't blend into mush or blend away, which is what some brow pencils can do. I like it. And you can see as far as me filling in, I go very lightly in the center, just kind of swishing it up. And then I fill in the sparse areas. I normally create an arch. I'll draw it out. And then I'll lightly lengthen. And then I just kind of fill in where it looks like I need extra hairs. Normally I'm not this precise, so I kind of just scribble it in and hope for the best. But you can see the difference between my filled in versus just the brow product. I'm going to go in just a little bit with a pencil right here to just fill in the areas and make whatever I got going down here better. You can see after this one use what I mean by it gets dull. It's just not as pointy anymore, but I really do like this. I think it's nice. I think it did the job. At the end of the day, it's kind of like a brow pencil is a brow pencil. You know, how different can they all be from one another? This one's very pricey. So we'll say the legendary brows it's like glue. It doesn't exactly dry down. Like, it doesn't make your lashes feel hard. It makes your lashes feel a little bit more sticky. So I feel like you can kind of push them in so that they'll stay in place better. Okay, last up, you guys, we have the Brow Fix Clear Brow Gel. Just a good old eyebrow gel. This is $23. It's brand new to the line, made in France. Where's the other pencil made? Huh, and the eyebrow pencil we just used is made in South Korea. Wow, all different kinds of places she sourced for the products. So there's only one color. It's a clear brow gel that is long-lasting 24 hours. Sets brows all day with an invisible finish. So I'm just going to do this brow right here. I'm picky about my brow gels. I've been using ABH for years, and I've recently fallen in love with in the last couple of years. The benefit is really nice, and I also, surprisingly, really love Sigma. Nobody talks about Sigma's brow stuff, but they have some of my favorite eyebrow products. And we're gonna leave it at that. I gave myself a little bit of a fluffier vibe today. I don't normally do that, but I feel like going fluffy like this is a really good way to tell if you like the product or not. Because if my brows can stay standing up, then you know it's a good product. And something I would like to point out, I really like the spoolie on this. It's like extra fibrous, and the fibers are nice and short, so they really brush out and separate the lashes. And because there's so many, they separate it, as opposed to a spoolie where the fibers are further apart. They don't quite grab all of the lashes. This is nice, fibrous. I don't even know if fiber is the right word, but the hairs are very close together, which really makes it comb through the lashes. Okay, so, and I want this to dry down, and then I'll kind of tell you how it feels. But I really like the Legendary Brows Tinted Brow Gel a lot, because this is the kind of product that I like to wear kind of every day to work. And I really like how it's that more sticky kind of finish, because I just feel like that makes the brows more flexible and more natural throughout the day. And I really like how easy it was to use. You didn't get too much color on your eyebrows, and it didn't make my eyebrows look a mess. They just tamed them and gave them a slight tint. I really like the eyebrow pencil as well. However, I do think it is a bit pricey. I don't see myself repurchasing this as of now. Okay, we'll see. Time will tell, but I just feel like with eyebrow pencils, you run through them like water, and this is very, very good. Nothing bad to say about it, but I'd rather purchase a brow pencil that I can get for cheaper that works just as good as this. Let's see how the Brow Fix is looking. So it doesn't give the brows a hard feeling either. So I feel like the brows have some flexibility as well. I don't necessarily like that though. I kind of like when a clear brow gel does make my brows feel like hairspray has run through them. So it leaves a softer finish. So if you like that, you might like this. Let me zoom out so you can kind of see how we are looking. I know they look very different. Different products, different vibes, but I just want to test both for you guys. So overall, from what I can tell, I really like all of the brow products that I've tried so far. I don't think the brow pencil is a repurchase. Legendary Brows, the tinted brow gel, I'm here for. I really, really like it. Time will tell with the clear brow gel. So what I'm going to do, I don't exercise with makeup on ever, and I'm not going to today. I'm going to take off all my makeup, but I'm going to leave the brows because it is like 8 o'clock that I'm filming this. Obviously, I can't get a wear tested. So I figure the next best thing would be for me to actually do a workout test. So we'll do that tonight, and I'll be back on camera after my workout to tell you if the gels held up, if the color held up, if it leaked on my face. I don't know. Anyways, stay tuned. All right, guys, so we are just gonna do a quickie. Ignore this friend right here. He's very, very angry. My skin's been doing so good, and then hormonal acne came and bit me in the butt. But anyways, that is not our focus right now, the eyebrows. So I didn't do a super sweaty workout by any means. I did 30 minutes on my Peloton, but I had a fan on me the whole time, so I didn't get too sweaty. I got damp, but not super drippy sweaty, and then I did a little bit of Pilates. But, you know, my skin got damp, and as you can see, the hairs are still pointing in the direction that they were in originally. I will say the brow gel, it did dry down to be a little bit harder than I mentioned, but it's not super crispy. You know how some brow gels can make your eyebrows feel crispy? I kind of like the crispiness, but if you don't like the crispiness, this doesn't have much crispiness to it and it still holds its shape. Again, the brow gel I think is really nice. It feels nice and thick, and I like everything that I tried today. Now, are these brow products that I'm going to continue to repurchase again and again and again? Most likely not, especially with the brow pencil and the clear brow gel, but I know I'm going to enjoy my time using them. Let's get away from my face. I know I'm like so cute. I can't believe I'm showing myself like this on camera, but I wanted to do some sort of wear test since I didn't have the time to do like a full day wear test. So I'm very, very happy and I love the way that this brow looks. This one, not my best look, but it's fine. Anyways, that is all I have for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you aren't subscribed to my channel already, I would love it if you would consider taking the time to do so. If you have not yet filled out a Sephora squad testimony for me, I would really, really appreciate it. And yeah. That's all I have for today's video. I will see you guys in the next one. Have a good one.